Now, can you two tell me the story of how you two met?
Well, a girl was swept off her feet by a guy at a dance. The boy whose eye I captured, I won't even say he captured my eye, but I captured his eye, and he was persistent. He kept on, every time I'd get a chance to dance with somebody different, he would cut in. He was so rude. He was getting to be quite a pest, quite annoying. I got to change partners, he cut in again. And this kept happening. And it turned out that I spent the whole night actually dancing with this guy who was so rude and kept cutting in. This young scout, looking very dapper in his officer's uniform, offered to take me home. And he could not get to his car. It was impacted in a parking lot. So we started walking, intending to catch a bus. And at the first bus stop, the buses passed by without picking us up. So then, tell them the rest of the story, Pete.
Well, we started walking south down this part of the city because that's where you lived.
Market Street, and across Market Street, and then toward the approach of the freeway.
And I think we stopped somewhere for a quick bite to eat.
Yeah, we might have stopped at Zim's on Market Street.
That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
And we'd been at every bus stop, they just didn't stop, so.
And finally we got to where there was excavation for where the new freeway was going to be built.
Yeah.
All the way home, we talked and we laughed. We had such a good time just conversing with each other. And we got to my front door, and I said goodnight. And I stepped inside the apartment, and I leaned up with my back against the door. And I leaned against the door, and I said, "Oh, God, no, please, not you. You had really made an impact on me." And that moment felt very special, and I was scared about how special it felt. Life was never the same. We didn't know it wasn't going to be the same. It took a while for that. For us to figure that out, but
I met her and I loved her. All
day well,
I still do.
Well, in that case, you're talking about the fabled love at first sight.
Where her house was on a hill, went up and over and down, and I swear I was dancing. I was so happy. I had never had a time with as charming and wonderful a lady as this one. Never. And I liked her right then and there. And I kept pushing until she finally married me.
We dated for over 3 years. And one night, Sunday night, I'd been ill all day. And anyway, at the end of the day, I was feeling better. So you, my dear Pete, picked me up, and we went down to Dobbs' place, Dobbs' drive-in. Then you brought me home, and I was thinking to myself, you know, he better, I'm waiting for him to ask me, finally ask me, formally. And so then he said to me, "Hey, Phil," he said, "let's set a date." So that was his proposal, and I was ready for that. I was really ready for that. And here we are now. You didn't look like anybody I had ever met. You certainly did not fit any image I had of who would be my boyfriend. you were, I guess, fair-skinned, more or less blondish, and and you smoked a pipe. Yes, you did. You smoked a pipe. That does really, you know, look so cool. And you always had, I happened to like the aroma of your tobacco. It was an excellent choice.
Yeah, I also smoked cigarettes, but after we were married, I quit smoking entirely.
Well, anyway, he's a very nice, gentlemanly guy. And I look forward to walking and laughing with him in the future. His sense of humor was marvelous.